So today we're gonna start the machine called Blue. So ping 10 10 10 10 40, and we can see the TT value. So let's try with the nmap, the very first basic command. And 10 10 10 10 40. So yeah, this blue machine is depends on the Windows machine, जो कि easy machine है आपकी, but इसमें जो vulnerability है वो आप Metasploit use नहीं करो, बिना Metasploit के करना start करो. बहुत सारी machines जो होती है वो आप Metasploit से कर सकते हो, but जैसे मान लो कि जब आप CTF कर रहे हो या active machines कर रहे हो तो आप Metasploit use कर लो, but जब exam की बात आती है तो I will prefer कि Metasploit का कम use करके manual practice करो, क्योंकि सबसे ज्यादा मैनुअल में सबसे ज्यादा आपका इंपॉर्टेंट है. सो लेट इट बी. ओके सो इट विल टेक सम टाइम अवे हियर. इतना टाइम कैसे ले रहा है ये इतना. So the scan has been done, and over here we can see the port number 135/139/445 is open there, and we can see that it's a Windows 7 professional server spec. (clears throat) 135/139 is open over there. So what we can do, and through the we can see that there is some SMB's version. For example, this PC name is Harish PC. So the SMB service is 2 security mode, and we can see that the 135/139 is open. So this is a Samba server. For Samba server enumeration, we basically focus on some of the enumeration tools. For example, SMB map -h host 10 10 10 10 40. Access is denied. Let's use -p port 139. Finding open SMB port, authentication error occurred. So we can use port 445 over here. Still unable to execute any files. Let's try SMB client, client server communication with the capital L for the host 10 10 10 10 40 hyphen N. Don't ask me the password. And we can see that there were some shares, just like your C drive admin IPC share disk and user disk. Let's try to communicate with this one. Let's access the directory called share. And we can see that we are in with the SMB client because there was an anonymous access enabled. So ls karte hain. So we can see that we are on the, I don't know where we are, pwd. We are on the share directory, ls-all. Okay, let's try question mark. And let's try to use any of the commands, like let's try echo command, or we can try make directory. Let's see if we have a permission to make a file. Pro. access denied. We don't have the permission. Let's try to access the users directory. So we are in, let's say ls, and when I simply access the user directory, I can see that there are some file like default, dex api and public. Dr means directory. These are the files. This is the default files over there. Is it a file or a directory? Let's check. It's not a directory, I guess. It's a directory. And we can see that we are on the server, which is app data, desktop, document, downloads, favorite, links, music. Let's try to access the desktop. In the desktop, there is nothing over there. CD documents. Still, there is nothing. It's all empty over here. So the major part comes through SMB map. You have to client, you have to connect with the server, client server communication. It's not about attacking phase, it's all about recon, means enumerate. Recon is a key of success. Jitna aap enumeration karoge utna aap aage badhoge. Maine aapko pehle hi bola tha ki har ek port ko aapko check karna hai ki usme kaun si service chal rahi hai aur uske regarding port number aapko dhoondna hai. I can enumerate all these data over here on the server side, but it's a trap. For example, the port 445 over there, and it's showing us Windows 7 professional. So I can use smb.1, jo ki aapki nmap ki nsc scripts hai, powerful animation scripts hai. You can use nmap -fn script smb.1 asterisk or aapka target ki IP address. So over here, this will take a little bit of time. Wow. So one SMB one, which I told you last time, that these scripts are basically used for scanning the SMB vulnerable versions. The very first one that was your legacy, which was vulnerable to Net API, which is your Windows XP servers. But over here, you can see only one, which is your SMB MS-17010. MS-17010, which is your Akka Eternal Blue, and the state is vulnerable. So the main objective of this machine is to enumerate the services, and we can see that the server is vulnerable to MS-17010 Akka Eternal Blue. We can either use Metasploit to check if it is vulnerable or not. Let's try Metasploit, but we are not going to exploit, we just going to enumerate. So SMB Metasploit ke through hum isko check karenge ki ye vulnerable hai ki nahi. Theek hai, hum exploit nahi karne wale bina Metasploit ke karenge. For that case, let's use search Eternal Blue, and I'm gonna use only the auxiliary. Use auxiliary show options, and over here we have to figure out we have to put the our host, which is your victim IP address. So set our host 10.10.10.10.40, which is our target IP address, and show options. We can see that the port the victim IP address is 10.10.10.14, and the port number which we'll enumerate is 4445. And let's run. And we can see over here that the host is likely vulnerable to MS-17010 Akka Eternal Blue, which is your 64 bit. Eternal Blue works on 64 bit, and there are other 32 bits also. For that case, what we're gonna use? We're gonna use a tool called Auto Blue on the GitHub script. Auto Blue GitHub. This tool is basically used for your attacking phase. Either you can use AutoBlue, or there are other different tools also. So we can download this one. AutoBlue MS-17010 Master. So, मैं बता देता हूँ कि ये जो टूल है बेसिकली ये चेक करता है कि वो सर्वर वल्नरेबल है कि नहीं MS-17010. और ये कैसे कैसे आपको यूज करना है. आप शेल प्रिपरेशन डॉट एस एस चलाओगे पहले, फिर आप लिसनर एक्टिवेट करोगे अपना, फिर पॉन करने के लिए आप सिंपल ये यूज कर सकते हो. लेट मी शो यू हाउ डज इट वर्क्स. AutoBlue. Let's extract and let's share it over here. So the tool AutoBlue. LS. So first of all, we're gonna use Eternal Checker. और हमेशा याद रखना कि जब आप एक स्क्रिप्ट को यूज कर रहे हो तो उसमें देखना कि वो कौन सा लैंग्वेज यूज हो रहा है, मींस कौन सा टूल यूज कर रहे हैं चेकिंग करने के लिए. सो ये पाइथन फाइल है, सो इट्स विल बी रन एज अ नॉर्मल पाइथन आल्सो. फॉर दैट केस आई एम गोना यूज पाइथन इटरनल चेकर. लेट्स चेक इज इट वल्नरेबल टू MS-17010 और नॉट. 10.10.10.10.40. ओके सॉरी. As you can see that Windows 7 Professional is not patched. The target is not patched over there. Testing pipes done. So this is a vulnerable machine over here. Let's try to make exploit as per the instruction. Navigate to the shellcode directory in the repo and run shell.prepare. .sh. So we're gonna make our shell code according to the 64 byte also and 32 byte according, if you doesn't know the architecture of the target. So it will create a MSF Venom payload. So over here cd shellcode, and we're gonna run the shell.prepare.sh file, which is a shell script. So kernel shellcode compiled. Would you like to auto-generate a reverse shell with MSF Venom? I say yes. L host, the attacker's IP address. So let's check our IP address. We have an IP address of 10.10.10.14.2. So 10.10.10.14.2. L port, and L port is asking for the 64 byte of architecture. So we're gonna use 4448 for the 32 bit. We're gonna use 4449. Now he's asking me, do you want to generate a Metapetra shell or a regular shell? A Metapetra shell means a Metasploit listener, and regular shell is just like a CMD. So I'm going to use only the CMD architecture. So for that case, I'm going to use one to generate a regular shell, 0 to generate a stage payload, and 1 to stages payload, which is your shell command, obviously. And you can see over here, MSF Venom -P, Windows Architecture 64, Shell Reverse TCP, Flow Raw, -O, Output, Exit Function Threads, L Host, and L Port. And as you can see over here also, that it also making an architecture of 32 bits. So over here, you can see they had made a 64-byte and a 32-byte. For now, what are we going to do? We're going to activate our listener. Netcat numeric listening verbose port 4448. And I'm going to activate the Netcat also. Again with the 4449. So let's try this one. As per over here, Python eternal blue exploit 7.py target IP address with the shellcode you have made, path of the shellcode, which is sh.all binaries. So let's try this one. So I'm going to use Python for the eternalblue.py with the 10.10.10.10.40. And what I'm going to use over here is simply the shellcode that we have created. For the most important part, हमेशा एक चीज याद रखना, जब भी आप कुछ कर रहे हो तो मेजरली एनुमरेशन सबसे ज्यादा करो, क्योंकि उसमें आपको पता लगेगा कि आपके एक्सप्लॉइट कहां पे काम कर रहा है. स्पेस आपका शेल कोड, जहां पे अगर आपको पता नहीं कि आपके कौन से यूजर है तो आप sc.binall यूज कर लो, सबसे बेस्ट होगा. एंड हिट एंटर टू रन द 64 एंड 32 बिट्स. एंड वी कैन सी दैट वी हैव अ शेल ओवर हियर व्हिच इज 4448 एंड इट वाज नॉट वर्किंग ऑन द 4449. और सीधा आपको ये रूट एक्सेस देगा. इट्स ऑल अबाउट एनुमरेशन एंड एनुमरेशन.